And now creates a two-on-one the other way. Another chance. Rebound. Score! Kessel shot. Rebound. Kadri. And it is a 4-1 Toronto lead. As Lucic looks to the front. Gets it out front. A shot here. Score! Nathan Horton buries one. With 10:42 remaining, the Bruins back to within two. Out to Zdeno Chara with a shot. Changes direction to the right. Pat save by Reimer. Out to the point now. Bergeron across for Chara. He hammers one here. Save. Rebound. Can't score! Bruins score! Like they did last night. Late in game six. Out to the line. Jágr sets it up here. Bergeron far side. Krejci back to Bergeron. Bergeron with a high shot. And score! Bruins have scored to tie the game! Can you believe this? Chara starts it back, 20 seconds remaining in regulation. Marchand across the line. Reimer save, rebound, chance! Poked away by Reimer! Oh, he gave up a rebound, and the Bruins were unable to get it back on goal.
Peverley bounced over his stick when he was trying to control it. He wanted one more second to shoot it, and it bounced on him.
Back to the front again, it never got all the way through. Now Marchand with it, hands it off. Bergeron a shot, rebound, chance in front. Taking it there, puck comes free, score! Patrice Bergeron, who tied the game, has won it in overtime.
They keep the puck inside the zone. Marchand does a good job battling against Bronson to get it back. That's the initial shot by Bergeron. And then battle in front of the net. Bergeron gets free and comes in.
Several times on that shift, Bergeron showed tremendous patience.
Barzella with it now, drops it back. Johansson in, a rolling putt, walks in, Anderson down, he shoots at the side, goal, puts it, and scores! Marcus Johansson ties the game!
The puck's going to get shot here by Kuznetsov. It squeaks off of Anderson, and it's a foot over the goal line.
Kuznetsov kicks it back to Carlson. John Carlson for Justin Williams. Has a lane. In shoot. Anderson's in. Rebound. Score! Marcus Johansson, the series winner. And the Washington Capitals take it in six.
Not surprisingly, Justin Williams gets himself in the middle of the play. And Martin Marinson's not able to muscle Johansson off the front of the net. Right in front of the net, Johansson takes the rebound and chips it into the corner behind.
And off this time, it is now Pasternak and Krüger shot, he scores!
Starts from the draw. Bergeron and Marchand are out there for the Bruins, and it's sort of won by the Maple Leafs, but Krug gets the pass and he zips it. I guess there might have been a moving screen in front of him.
Whirled around behind, still trying to keep possession, roughed out there by Kevin Miller. Right back ahead, it's DeBrusk with a step. DeBrusk trying to get it ready, right, score!
Watch Gardner, he pivots inside, gets himself out of position. DeBrusk is able to get it to the forehand, and that's a nasty goal against Anderson. He's going to want that over again.
And for Jake DeBrusk, his fifth goal of the playoffs.
And then Pasternak. And then back in again, Zaitsev. Came on to Bergeron, out of
this started way earlier. Here's the Leafs trying to stretch it out, and Chara stays up on Marlowe and gets it right back up ice, and off go the Bruins, and Marchand with a hustle, Bergeron with the alertness, and Pasternak with a scorer's touch, breathing room for Boston.
Big one in front, picked up there by Riley Nash, back up to center ice, weaving his way along as Marchand, he's over!
Marchand with the flick of the wrist, a dagger in the heart of the Leafs.
A seventh game win at home by Boston. Final score 7-4 Bruins.
Nice chance here for Jake DeBrusk off a beautiful feed by David Pasternak, but once again, Frederik Andersen has that glove working.
DeBrusk trying to get by. Trying to shake loose at center, he got his stick back, Marchand, he scores! The Boston Bruins 4. Crossed by Achari, and Pirelli trying to wind his way through, and does. Pirelli, he scores!
He beats Hainsey, he dances past Riley, and snaps it past Anderson. That's a heck of a goal.
Marner able to bring it back out and gain the zone. Mitch Marner across the field.
Nyquist will deliver it deep. Moody, on a partial change, has the puck. It's a bingo. He scores! Liam Foudy gets the goal, and Columbus has a 2-0 lead. His first Stanley Cup playoff goal gives Columbus a 2-goal cushion.
All right, Brian's going to want to talk about the DH or whatever stupid goalie move there is down there. Just hold the post. Freddie Anderson's got to hold the post there. You can't let that in. That is a tough angle shot. I don't know where the rest of the Leafs were, though. He had plenty of time to walk in. And he does right there. But that one is... that's a bad goal.
Pass. Nobody there. Broken up by Foligno. The captain through center. Nick Foligno slashed. But he puts it away. And the Columbus Blue Jackets have a 3-0 lead.
A couple nights ago, I buried Toronto with 5 minutes to go. And they came back. But I think I'm going to hold the funeral out. Great character show by the Columbus Blue Jackets.
And terrific goaltending from Jonas Korpisalo. We had a shutout in game number one. Now through center. Moved in by Spets over the line. Janssen off a body. Captured by Texier. 9 seconds left. Spets up, holding on to it. He'll pump it through the slot. Off the wall. 3 seconds. What an effort here. With a capital lead, the Columbus Blue Jackets have qualified. They march on to round number one.
Pulling away, here's a 2-on-0. Caulfield gets it to Suzuki, he misscores! Montreal wins it! There will be a game 6 on Saturday night.
And the steal from Caulfield, who elects to go back to Suzuki. Caulfield could have shot this puck. He's got an incredible release. He gives it to Suzuki and right back, and there's no way Campbell can catch up.
Sherratt for Byron. And now Weber. Return pass for Byron, gets away. And Dermott doubles back, gives it away. Byron to the middle. Cut. Kotkaniemi scores! Get ready for game 7!
And here's Dermott. The puck on his stick. He tight turns back towards his net, loses it, it's right on the tape, and then the shot through the screen of Bogosian from Kotkaniemi, and it might have gotten a piece, and you can see that puck wobbling as it goes by Jack Campbell. But it's the turnover from Dermott, who's in for Rasmus Sandin, who turned over pucks in the last game, that led to goals against, and Kotkaniemi is the hero for Montreal to send them to game 7. How improbable was this? Especially when you take into account how this overtime went. It was 100% all Toronto Maple Leafs. But Montreal taking what was given to them.
Tyler Toffoli to the empty net and in! Montreal is 2:38 away from completing the comeback.
Face-off win. And the Leafs can't keep the puck in the zone. And a heads-up play from Staal. And look at that from Toffoli. and disbelief.
What a series. Shot it tight, they score. William Nylander has won. As he finally breaks the goose egg for Toronto with a minute 36 to go. This pass gets away, rolls out of the zone, and the Montreal Canadiens have completed the comeback. Shock and awe in Toronto. The Montreal Canadiens are on to the second round of the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Entry. Stamkos. Kucherov, he'll dance. Point, Kucherov, with a shot! And there is plenty of conversation after. Play it to the boards, Matthews sends it in. And game number six will go to overtime. Move it up top, Chernak, Cirelli, Chernak, tipped wide, Killorn in the slot. Marner. Matthews takes a spill. Here comes Hagel. Brandon Hagel to the slot. Shot taken. Campbell with a save. Braden Point wins it in overtime.
Late in period three, Hagel with the play to Killorn. And Point stops in front, slides it under Campbell, and the Leafs tap it into their own net. Hall tries to reach in to keep it out. So does Bunting, and they both tap it in. Looks like Bunting got more of it. Point's got the goal, and we've got a game seven coming back in Toronto.
It will be seventh heaven in Toronto Saturday night. Third career playoff overtime goal for Braden Point.
Muzzin breaks things up. Now Paul with the puck. Paul scores! His second of the game, and the Lightning go back on top, and it's 2-1 Tampa Bay.
And there's the play by Paul, kicking it up from his skate.
Time winding down, 3 seconds. Now Tavares turns, shoots, it's blocked, and the Tampa Bay Lightning will advance. They win game seven by the score of 2-1.
We want Florida! 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 We want Florida!
Control to the line, Mahura for Radko Gudas. Gudas, a wrist shot, score!
Carter Verhaeghe with the redirection. It's tied at two.
Ekblad flies through center, gloved down by Reinhardt. Reinhardt was alone, so he decided not to enter until he's got some reinforcements, and then he finds his way in. Reinhardt changing sides of the ice for Lundell. Return to Reinhardt, right in front, he scores! Sam Reinhardt gives the Panthers a 3-0 lead in the series.
You read about, here's the play by Ekblad, and what do you know, a high flipper out of the zone. There's the pullback by Reinhardt, so calmly, and now he's able to re-enter the zone with a nifty little move, uses the back of the net, and now it gets punched back by Lundell, the goaltender Joseph Woll. He's looking over his left shoulder. I've often talked to Reinhardt about the curve on his stick. He's got a pretty good toe curve right there with a fat blade, and he easily jams this between the legs of Woll, who came in under a tough circumstances and played terrific, but the young goaltender will get the loss in this overtime session.
Goal comes at 3:02 of overtime, and it wasn't the post, it was the five hole on the wraparound from Reinhardt.
A couple of Leafs collide, and the Panthers have numbers up ice. Radko Gudas going to the net. Cousins waits, drags, shoots, scores! Series clincher, Nick Cousins, and the Panthers are moving on.
An incredible moment for this coaching staff in Florida. And the Panthers will advance to the conference finals. Turnover down deep. A good play by Ratko Gudas to cut that off. And then I thought at this point here, Cousins was going to drop it to Bennett. He's the late man looking for the one-timer. Cousins doesn't do that. And look at Ratko Gudas go to the front of the net, cause a disturbance, and allow Cousins to score on a beautiful wrist shot right there.